Yep, he's back. He's here. The one, the only, Maxy Smythe. Come on out here, Maxy. Yeah, well, Sheila's at her mother's, you know, left me here with the cat, so, you know, now I gotta, you know, fend for myself here, you know. And she calls me, and she says, "Sweetheart, please, please, will you pick up the cake I ordered at the, you know, at the grocery store? I know it's your day for shopping." Well, yeah, it is my day for shopping. All right, tell you what, how about if I bring the cake up and we take it to your room at your mother's house? And she says, "I'll make it up to you," you know, and I said, oh, that's nice. She said, "Tonight I'll make it up to you on the phone." "You're going to do that thing, aren't you?" And she said, "Let's not talk about it now, but listen, I got a cake for Mother. It's her birthday, so will you pick it up at our grocery store?" And then I stopped. And I said, "Sweetheart, listen, I'm not going to be going to our regular store." She says, "What do you mean you're not going to our regular store? That's where the bakery is." And I said, "Well, no, I'm going to go to the sister store, the other one, kind of the uptown one." She goes, "What do you mean the uptown one? I mean, that's our store is right downtown there." And I said, "Sweetheart, listen, it's just that, you know, somebody put a bug in my ear and said that, you know, I should try to get away from the inner city one, you know, I mean, the one we normally use. I mean, it's where the poor folk are shopping, you know. I mean, I know I'm poor, I know, but if I can, I'll take it up a step, you know, and go to, you know, that other store. It's in the other part of town." And she says, I don't know what I'm going to do with you. "Well, you have to go to our store, and you got to stop being a snob. And you have to go to our store because that's where the cake is." And I said, all right, okay. You know, I just thought I'd mention it, you know. Oh, so that's the kind of shit I got to go through, you know, just to get a little something, you know, at night on the friggin' phone, for Christ's sake, you know. So I get to the store, you know, I park, the parking lot's, you know, jammed, the place is crowded, you know, and I'm coming around a corner, and I bump right into that friggin' robot thing that's been, you know, driving around, you know. I bump right into it, you know, and this woman, you know, nearby says to me, "Oh, wouldn't it be nice if they'd, you know, bend down and pick something up, for Christ's sake?" And I said, "Yeah." And then she said to me, "Oh, you know, he's got his own website." And I said, "You got to be kidding me, he's got his own website." She said, "Yeah, and they had a birthday for him the other day, too." And I'm looking at this thing beeping, you know, and it's trying to, you know, get around me. And I'm thinking, Jesus Christ, what in the fuck have we come to? But I got to get this shopping done. Get in and out of here. Right? I mean, this is war now, right? So I'm hitting everything I can, you know. Yeah, all the paper shit's gone, you know. So, I'm doing other shit. And, you know, I'm getting what I can. Got to get the pizza. Get the friggin' pizza, you know. My brand's not there. So I got to go, you know, with some other brand. Oh, man, I tell you, this is rough, you know. And then on the way there, I get a text from Sheila. She won't friggin' call me. You know, she's got to text me. You know, I'm in the car, and there it says, "Oh, and don't forget to use our own bags. They're in the back seat, you know. That's where I left them," she's telling me. And then and then another text comes, and she says, "Oh, and don't forget to, you know, spend a few bucks on some canned shit for that food pantry thing they got there. Okay?" So, Jesus Christ, you know. This is what I got to go through, you know, just to get a little something tonight on the friggin' phone, for Christ's sake. Oh, man, it better be good tonight. Oh. Anyway, so this is it. This is what we're doing now. All right, so I finally get out of there. I get past that friggin' robot piece of shit, and I get into the car, and I head straight to Sheila's mother's house, you know, to drop off the cake. You know, and so I got it nice and back in the back seat, safe and sound, and I get to the front of the house. I park and I walk it up to the door, and I tap on the door, and Sheila, she's right there behind the door. She opens the door a crack. "Maxy, how are the cats doing? Are you feeding them properly? Are you doing the kitty litter properly?" And I say, "Sweetheart, how are you?" And I say, hey, when are you coming home, for Christ's sake? And screw the cat. Here's your friggin' cake. Yeah, happy birthday. And I know your mother never liked me. She never liked me. Fuck the kitty.